Assalamualaikum and hi semua. Welcome back. So today we continue our online class on chapter 6 part 2. Okay, on the part 2, we will cover on the parking impact, parking policy, type of parking and parking study. So the impact of parking will referring to the availability, convenience and cost of parking effects mode chose. Okay, so an owner of private automobiles is likely to use their automobile to access their destination if parking is a plentiful. Parking is a convenience located, cost of parking is reasonable. An owner of a private automobile is not likely to use their automobile and choose to use alternative if parking is a scarce. Parking in inconvenience and cost of parking is expensive. So, parking affects the vitality of community, commercial and business center, transit system and airport. Sufficient parking is important when making a trip for social visit, to keep business alive, to facilitate transport system, buses, train, LRT and air travel. A delay impact is a parking affects the circulation of traffic in downtown area. Like a sufficient parking reduce the time spent by the driver to find parking space, is a making traffic flow smoothly. Okay, the policy for the parking is to make sure to strike a compromise between the amount of the curb space devoted to parking and for moving vehicle. To make provision, parking of delivery vehicles, short-term parks and long-term parkers. To design parking load and their operation so that the street traffic is not adversely affected by the increase and increase of parking parkers. And then to ensure that interest of business establishment along the street is enhanced by good parking arrangements. To ensure that parking policy are complementary, for example, car parks adjacent to bus station and road will enhance bus ridership. Then to preserve the characters of the neighborhood by restrict parking and enforce land use control. The last one is to control parking supply and demand through the pricing mechanism, encourage short-term parking and discourage long-term parking by serve to enhance the CBD. Okay, this is the policy time of the picture for the parking policy, right? Okay. On the parking study is therefore used to determine the demand for and the supply of the parking facilities in the area, the projection of the demand, and the view of various interest groups and how best to solve the problems. So on the parking study, we involve and include the financial feasibility, functional design, structural design, and the demand study. So type of the parking study in the comprehensive, limited, site specific. Sample must be done carefully to order to prevent bias to oversampling of the short-term parkers. Some of the kind of vehicle will park around the long terms, like 1 to 3-4 hours, and this one is just short terms. One is like about 10-15 minutes, right? Okay, type of parking facilities will be divided into two. First is a public parking. The second one is the private parking. For every single of public parking and private parking will be separately onto the off-street parking then on-street parking, right? So we go through the public parking types. For the off-street parking, on the public parking usually in park lot that with multi-purpose building or exclusive parking structure. Example like here lah. So they are the specialized on the off-street parking. For the on-street parking, may be free or not. It may be regulated or unregulated. Example, no parking during the rush hour, no overnight parking. So, it's some kind of the on-street parking ataupun kita panggil as a curb parking. Right? So, this is a private parking. Also divide by two, off-street private parking and on-street private parking. So, for the off-street private parking, include home or apartment building, garage, stall, driveway or affiliate specific parking permit required. So this is some of the example picture on the on-street parking and off-street parking. For the on-street parking, if a type of the parking like a parallel parking and angle parking. Okay. Before we go for the calculation for the parking study, we need to understand definition of the parking terms. So for the first term is a space hour. Space hour is a unit of parking that define the use of single parking space for the period 1 hour. Then for the parking volume is the total number of vehicle that park in the study area during specific length time, usually a day. Then parking accommodation is the number of parked vehicle in the study area at any specified time. This data can be plotted as a curve of parking accumulation again with time. We show the variation of the parking accumulation during the day. Then the parking load is the area under accumulation curve between two specific time. It's really given a number space hour used during specific period of time. Then a parking duration is the length of the time of vehicle is parked at the parking bay. When the parking duration is given as a average, it gives an indicate of how frequently a parking space become available. And then parking turnover is the rate of user parking speeds. It's obtained by dividing the parking volume for the specified period by the number of parking space, right? So parking demand and is the number of vehicle was driver desired to park at specific location in general area. Usually expressed as a number of vehicle during the peak parking hour. And last one is the parking terms is a parking supply. Is the number of parking space available for use. Okay, this is the definition on term of the parking. Okay, so we go through. For the parking study, have a four methodology. The first one is the inventory of existing parking facilities. The relevant characteristic usually list including first one is the type and number of parking space. It's a parking facility. Okay, so dia kena tahu apakah jenis-jenis dan bilangan parking space yang disediakan untuk setiap parking facilities. Time operation and limit of duration of parking. So normally dia ada mention kan. So just boleh park during daripada pagi sampai malam ataupun boleh the whole day. Okay. Time of the ownership sama ada is a public or private. Parking fee. Biasa dia akan letak sign how much the parking fee. Restriction on use. Open or close to public. Other restriction. Probable degree of permanency. Probably degree of permanency sama ada permanent ataupun as the temporary. The second methodology is a collecting of parking data. So in the collecting parking data will be divided in two. Is one is the accumulation, the second one is a turnover and duration. Okay, accumulation is obtained by checking the amount of parking during regular interval on different day of the week. The check are usually carried out on the hour or 2 hour. So sama ada kita buat hourly or 2 hour basis between 6 a.m. and 12 midnight. This is the suggestion of the accumulation times. Okay, this is a turnover and duration obtained by collecting data on the sample of parking space in the given blocks. Okay, it's done by recording the license plate. So recording a license plate of the vehicle parked on the each parking space. Okay. Nanti this why we go to a sum of card or example to make it clear on this methodology. Okay, then identification of the parking generation. This phase involves identifying parking generator. For example, shopping center or transit terminal and locating this on a map, on the map of the study area. So this come kind of the generous parking generator. And the last one is a collection of information on parking demands. Information on parking demand obtained by the interviewing driver at the various parking facilities list during the inventory. An effort should be made to interview all driver using parking facilities on the typical weekday between 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. Information so should include trip origin, purpose of trip, and driver destination after parking. Okay, what is the method collection parking data? Is a three kind of the collecting parking data. First one, we calculate using the ins and outs. All vehicles, this one is a one, is a vehicle parked in the focus area are count at the beginning of the survey period. Then the vehicle entering existing, they are counted. This method can yield the overall accumulation and occupancy only. So whatever some of the student we use, conducted the project on the using parking, will be applied any type of the method suitable on the project. So the second one is a fixed period. All vehicle parked in the focus area are count at the beginning of the survey period. Occupancy count are conducted every 15 minutes to 1 hour. This method may be missed short term of parking and may be difficult to private garage. Okay. So next is the license plate survey. So this some kind of the survey form. So ada information of parking space. Sometime of the parking ada numbering kan space. Okay, so whatever is a 1, 2, 3 example lah. Right? So just locate the parking space information. So we allocate the interval. So we allocate in every single 5 minutes intervals. So duration for the collection data of the survey. Most accurate and realistic data because every parking space is monitoring a fixed interval. This method is very labor intensive and it enters certain liability problem. This can be done by partly omitting the first or last digit of the license plate. Maksudnya kita nak kurangkan, is a list now, kita tak perlu nak tulis overall order number plate of vehicle. So others the parking study method will be applied is like a photograph, parking meter revenue and attendant receipt. So just choose whatever the kind of the method we are suitable to conduct on the parking study. So we go through the analysis of the parking data. Analysis of parking data include the summarize, coding and interpreting the data so that relevant information required for decision making can be obtained. So the relevant information included the following kind of the number and duration for vehicle park, number and duration of vehicle illegal park, space hour demand of for parking, supplies of parking facilities. The analysis is required to obtain information. The first two items are straightforward. It usually involves simple arithmetical and statistical calculation. Data obtained from this item are then used to determine the parking space. So, for the analysis, parking data is a space hour demand for parking. The symbol is a D. This is the equation, right? So, we go through straightforward. So, we'll be explained detail on the example. It's more very clear and easy to understand. So this is the space hour supply equation. The symbol is S. Adequate analysis. This is the formula. And the last one is probability of recession. And the symbol is P. Okay, so this some the quick exercise. Okay, it's previously in the methodology of the parking data will be mention about the parking duration and parking turning. So this is the equation, simple equation to calculate the parking duration and parking turnover. So for parking duration, is a number of observation multiple interval divided by number of vehicle, while the parking turnover number of parked vehicle divide by number of parked space. Okay, so we go to quick exercise example. We give the license plate survey. This is information. We get the space number, space description example that is using the type of the meter to measure the interval time for vehicle park on the load space. Okay, the interval. So interval is 15 minutes, every single of 15 minutes. The start of 9 and up at the 11:15. So we need to calculate the parking duration space for 109. So here, right? So the formula for the parking duration is number observation multiplied by interval divided by number of vehicle. So for the space number 109, the number observation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 observation. Multiple is in between is 50 minutes. So multiple by 50. And divide by number vehicle. So just calculate yang ada number plate on this. Sebab it is a repeated symbol untuk this vehicle. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So divide by 5. So we get the 24 minutes per vehicle. Then the for the parking turnover, they not space between 1 to 112. So in between here. Right? Period. So you just count dia kata number of parked vehicle, just count the number plate vehicle. Right? So it's a 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. So ada 12 vehicles parks and divide by number of parking space. Dia ada 1, 2, 3, 4. So ada 4. So kita dapat 3 vehicle per space. Just simple one to calculate. For more understanding how to use the equation for parking duration and parking turnover. So we go through the example. Example 6.1. Okay, the question is, an office parking garage has the following characteristic. Hours of operation is 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. So, duration is 14 hours. Number of parking space, the garage is 500. 500 space. So, 80% commuter. 80% is a commuter, which average hour duration is 8 hours. 10% is a visitor. Average 2 hour. The remaining are shopper. So the remaining maksudnya dia ada another 10%. Dia ada average 3 hours. Okay. However, observation made at the garage indicate that 50% visitor during peak hour. 50% visitor during peak hour. 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. and 1 to 30 a.m. do not find parking. So duration is 10 to 12 and also 1 to 3 p.m. do not find parking. How many additional, so dia minta kita calculate additional space should be added the garage to meet the demand. So whatever yang visitor during the PIM also can comply, then kita akan provide dia punya any parking on during the peak hour. So the solution is we calculate the peak hour demand. So the commuter we calculate 80% multiple by space 500, the duration will park is 8 hours, so dapat 3200. And the visitor is 10% multiple 500 space times 2 hours, get a 100 space per 100 space hour. The balance is 10% for the shopper, 10% multiple with 500 parking times a 3 hour, so get a 150 space hour. So demand not served if 50% multiple 500 parking space multiple 4 hours. So 10, 11, 12 is a 2 hour. 1 to 3, 2 is a 2 hours. So total up is a 4 hours. So get a 300 space hour yang not served. So total speed hour demand, kita total up all the single value yang kita dah kena sama ada yang provided or not served. So total is the 3,750. Total space hours served, just consider yang dapat parking this area only, this amount only. So get the 3,450 space hour. Balance is a 300 yang not served. So the number of additional space are needed, 300 space divided by 4. So we need the 75 space. Okay, this is how to calculate the space for the adequate or not for the area. So we go through the another example. So example 6.2, it will observe during 8 hours study that 96 vehicle enter the park lot of the local electronic store. The park lot has only 5 parking space. Customer park their car for average of 50 minutes. Calculate probability the incoming vehicle will not find a parking space. So dia minta kita kira probability incoming vehicle not find the parking space. So first thing kita need to calculate the adequate of the parking space. Okay, so the Q value is the 96 vehicle divided by 8 hours. So this is the number duration vehicle are parked over there. So get the 12 vehicle per hour. The time duration is a 50 minute. The average value is a 50 minute. We convert to hours. So make sure we converted to unit hours. So just put using this equation adequate of the parking space. So the Q multiplied by T. So we get the 3 vehicle per hour. So then we calculate the probability. So use the probability equation. Key in whatever information we get for this question and get the 0.11, right? So the conclusion is entering vehicle has a 11 chance to be rejected. So because they have a 0.11 probability, this one 11, so we convert in the percentage. As a result, the electronic store lost on one of each 10 customer entry there. This parking facility is not adequate. Sebab ada 11% yang akan di-reject. Okay. Okay, so done for the part 2 topic on the parking. So we go the activity 3. The owner of parking, this is the question for the activities. We need all of you guys to answer for this activity and upload in the Google Classroom. So just get a sketch of paper ataupun boleh directly write on the computer to answer this activity and upload it in the Google Classroom in the tab activity folder and activity 3. Okay. That's all for today. We will continue the next part. It's a part 3 for the next class. Okay, thank you.